Hello everyone, welcome back to the Chemical Engineering at Aspen channel. And as you know, these days we are focusing on the module of Chemical Reaction Engineering. So in this regard, we are bringing the lecture number 14 for our valuable viewers. So as you know that we are focusing on the building block number 3, which is stoichiometry. And in our previous lecture, we had developed stoichiometry table, concentration terms, and we had solved an example related to the batch systems. Now today we will prepare or develop a stoichiometry table for the flow systems. We will derive the concentration terms for the flow systems, and then we will do derivations for the liquid phase systems. There are derivations for the gas phase systems, but that will be taken care of in the next lecture. So let's assume a flow system in which 1 mole of A reacts with B over A moles of B, produces C over A moles of C plus D over A moles of D. Obviously, you know that why it is written like this, because we have made the stoichiometry coefficient of the limiting reactant as 1, which was A, and divided the whole equation by the small a, which is stoichiometry coefficient of species A. As you can see that entering flow rates in the system are FA0, and if you remember our previous lecture, that naught means inlet, and the simple, if you see it like this, that FA0 means the flow rate of A at the inlet of the reactor, or initial molar flow rate of A, while F of A is final flow rate of A. Similarly, FB0 is initial flow rate of B, and FB is final flow rate of B. A and B are consuming in this system, while C, D are producing in the system, and I is inert in the system. Now we will now in the same way prepare the stoichiometric table for the flow systems. First, we will define the species A, B, C, D, I. I is inert, A and B are reactants, C and D are products. Now, first we need to define feed rate to the reactor. So for A, it will be FA0, B, it will be FB0, C and D, FC0, FD0 respectively, and for inert, it will be FI0. But if you remember our previous lecture, we had defined a vector theta, and that represented initial moles of I divided by initial moles of limiting reactant, Ni0 over Na0. In the same way, theta of I will be Fi0 over Fa0. So accordingly, theta of I is equal to Fi0 over Fa0. And if we say theta of B, it will be Fb0 over Fa0. So if you replace here Fb0 over Fa0, Fa0 will be cancelled out with Fa0. So accordingly, it will also be Fb0. So we can write Fb0 as theta B into Fa0. Similarly, Fz0 as theta C into Fa0. Fd0 is theta D into Fa0. And Fi0 is equal to theta I into Fa0. And the sum of all of these will be Fd0. As you remember, we have said that the total number of moles at the inlet are Nt0. So similarly, in the flow system, it will be Fd0. Now for the change, which is in mole per time, the change for the limiting reactant will be minus Fa0x. For the second reactant, it will be minus B over A into Fa0x. For the product, it will be plus C over A into Fa0x. For the product D, it will be plus D over A Fa0x. And we have seen that as well, that for the reactants, the negative sign will be used, while for the products, positive sign will be used, and it will be multiplied by its stoichiometric coefficient. So 1, B over A, C over A, D over A, and for inert, there will be no change in the system. Now to calculate the remaining, we have to add up these two values. So FA, the final flow rate, is FA0 minus FA0x, or we can say it as FA0 into 1 minus x. When we sum these two, FA0 will be common from these, and that will be F of B is equal to FA0 theta B from this, and minus B over A x. This will be calculated. For FC, once we add these two, and taken Fa0 common from this, it will be theta C plus C over A into X. And you can see Fc is equal to Fa0 theta C plus C over A into X. In the same way, it will be for F of D. Similarly, theta C is replaced by theta D and C is replaced by D, and the rest of the expression will remain the same. And for Fi, that is equal to theta I Fa0, as you have seen that there is no change in the system. So once we add up all these, it will become as Fd is equal to Fd0 plus D over A plus C over A minus B over A minus 1 Fa0x. And if you remember that we had labeled this part or denoted this part as sigma, which represented over there as change in total number of moles over moles of A reacted. Here it will be also the same. So FD is equal to FD naught plus sigma FA naught X. That is the final equation which we have derived from the system. And if you remember, for the batch system, it was NT is equal to NT naught plus sigma NA naught X. So the pattern is almost the same, the only change in its units, that there it was mole and here it is mole per time. For the derivation of concentration terms, we know theta I is equal to Fi naught over Fa naught, that is also equal to Ci naught over Ca naught, and that is equal to Yi naught over Yi naught. We had already seen that in our previous lecture. So we know Ca is equal to Fa over V. Now here it is volumetric flow rate. If you remember, in batch system we had said Na over V, where N over V, N was number of moles, V was volume, so mole per cubic decimeter. Here it is Fa, flow rate, mole per time. So volumetric flow rate is volume per time, so time is cancelled out with time and it will be mole per cubic meter or mole per volume. And Fa is equal to Fa naught into 1 minus X over small V, which represents the volumetric flow rate. Similarly for Cb, if you see, is equal to Fb over V, and is equal to, we can also write it as Fb naught minus B over A Fa naught X over V. For C of C, it is Fc over V, Fc naught plus C over A into Fa naught X. Or if you take Fa naught common from here, then this term will go to theta C. And similarly, C of D is equal to Fd over V, Fd naught plus D over A Fa naught X over V. So this is how the concentration terms are derived for the flow systems. Now based on that, based on this value of V, we can divide the system into two parts. One is the liquid phase system and one is the gaseous phase system. We will derive the concentration terms for the liquid systems. We know that for the liquid systems, there is a negligible change in fluid volume when no phase changes are taking place. So accordingly, we can take small v, which is the volumetric flow rate at the outlet, is equal to the inlet volumetric flow rate. So accordingly, now you look at this. This value is now v naught. So Fa naught over V naught will become as Ca naught. So Ca is equal to Ca naught into 1 minus X. Similarly, Cb is equal to Fb over V naught. Fb was equal to that it is Fa naught theta b minus b over A. So this is divided by V naught, and accordingly this term becomes as Ca naught. Similarly, this term becomes as Ca naught. This term becomes as Ca naught. This will become as Ct. This will become as C of C. This will become as C of B, and this will become as C of A. So in the same way, the next terms are used. Like you can see here, C of B is equal to Ca naught bracket theta B minus B over A into X. For C, it will be Fc over V naught or Ca naught theta of C plus C over A into X. And likewise for D, it will be C of D is equal to Fd over V naught Ca naught theta D plus D over A into X. For the liquid system, its derivation was very, very simple, that we have simply assumed initial is equal to final volumetric flow rate, as we have assumed in the batch systems. But once we go to the gaseous systems, this derivation is not simple like that. So accordingly, a specialized lecture, which will be lecture number 16 on CRE module, will be delivered next time. So that's it from today's lecture. I hope you have enjoyed the lecture. I would request that you study both batch and flow systems in detail to understand the next lecture on CRE module. So that's it from today's lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos on this channel.